Well, aloha and good afternoon. How y'all doing? Good. Everybody comfortable? Seatbelts, headsets all the way around. Everybody can hear me yet? Well, my name's Chad. I'll be your pilot and tour guide. Y'all got a verbal briefing on the way out, right? All right. Any questions about that? None? Y'all want to go fly? All right. Let's do it. Sit back and enjoy the ride. The mics will be off till we get outside the airspace. I'll talk to you then. Everybody say up, up, and away. We got the microphones back on. There's one microphone up front to share, two microphones in the back to share. Y'all can pass them back and forth. When you use them, talk into the tip. They don't work too good like this, but if you'll talk right into the tip, push the button, speak loudly, should pick up where everybody can hear you. I may have to go what a couple of times just because I'll be talking with other aircraft and air traffic control, but we'll get her done. So we're cruising south right now, making our way over one of the local macadamia fields below us here, the curious looking square layouts on the ground. Short trees are magnite trees. Tall trees are Norfolk pines. The Norfolk pines protect the small trees from strong winds. If that weren't the case, then I guess the nuts would get knocked off the tree onto the ground too prematurely. And then we wouldn't have all those tasty chocolate treats that they make with them. I was kind of surprised. They don't just make chocolate treats. They got garlic flavor and wasabi and all wasabi and all other kind of fun things. So the spot we flew over, there was a factory-looking area there. Part of that's Mount Aloha's processing facility. The other half is a visitor center you can do a little kind of fun tour of. The funnest part of the tour to me was the samples they give out. So, yeah, it's kind of good. Well, let's see here. Judith and Lewis, where are y'all from?
Toronto.
All right. Well, this is a nice temperature change this time of year?
Fabulous.
And Larry and Karen, where are y'all from?
North Dakota, Minnesota.
All right. Also probably a pretty decent temperature change.
Yes.
And Sandra and Ronald, where are you two from?
Australia.
We got a lot of Aussies on that boat, I guess. You guys riding the cruise ship?
Yep.
All right. Yeah, seems like every flight today we've had some folks from Aussie. What part of Australia from?
New South Wales.
What part of New South Wales?
Newcastle.
Oh, one second, sorry. Sometimes they start talking and some of these noisy military aircraft can't hear anything but blah, 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 blah. And it blocked you out. All right, again, what part of New South Wales?
Newcastle, north of Sydney.
Well, a little bit louder?
Newcastle, north
Newcastle.
Of
Sydney. Love Newcastle. Well, it's been a few years since I've been in Newcastle, but somebody told me that something happened, like does the train still run up there? Did they stop a train from running up that far or what?
Yeah, they have.
They stopped it?
Yes.
I remember beautiful and hilly. See, I'm trying to remember it didn't really matter. I was trying to remember the name of the beach down there. I thought it was Red something or whatever, bird, I don't know.
Redhead.
Redhead, yeah, there you go.
I live near there.
Radios will be a little quieter here for a couple of minutes, so I might have missed part of that, but we are cruising down towards the town of Pahoa. So off our nose, next little town out in the distance, again, it's Pahoa Town. And that was a spot that you might remember from the news, even if you hadn't been to the Big Island before, because it was almost famous, because it was almost covered up by lava. Lava flowed down the hill from Kilauea from the Pu'u'oho vent, and almost came through town.
How far is that?
I've never actually clocked the total distance. It's probably about 9 miles or so, give or take a smidge. So, yeah, quite a distance. It actually took it about 4 months to make that trip. Got up to speeds of about 400 yards per day. And they obviously did not know when the lava was going to stop, so they started making preparations for it to come through town across the highway. Started putting a lot of red cinder and insulation around the telephone poles to try to prevent it from, to keep electricity flowing to what they could. But it stopped just before getting there. There's only one structure that was consumed by the lava. It was over next to that green patch of grass. Actually, the whole thing used to be green grass. Now half of it's lava now. After that structure was consumed is when the lava stopped. And we might call that lucky. But if we ask the Hawaiian neighbors down here, they'll tell us not luck, it's Madame Pele. After she received the sacrifice that was that structure that was consumed, she chose to stop the lava, save the town. Lava has not flowed this way again since. Now, I gotta say, it is important to know and fun to know if you hadn't thought about it. That black stuff is the same stuff that makes up the whole Hawaiian Island chain. So, even directly below us, if we landed and took a shovel to it, we'd run right through the green stuff into the black lava below. If we wanted to get to the bottom of the pile of lava directly below us, we'd have to go through about 22,000 feet of lava before we got to the bottom of the ocean, where all of this originates from. Well, if you have any questions about the island, feel free to throw them out there. If I don't have an answer, I'll just make one up.
Flying here
today? I've been flying along about seven or so years now, maybe close to eight.